Hey guys, this is the Lowdown, and like we promised, there is plenty for us to dive in. So we're going to get straight into it. The first thing we want to talk about, of course, is game one of the conference semifinals in the West and in the East. Anant, tell me.
Yes, well, I haven't mentioned it, but I now feel confident talking about who I think makes it from the East. The Philadelphia 76ers just beat the Boston Celtics in Game 1, and it has me convinced that they are going to make it to the finals.
I don't think so.
Let's get nerdy for a second, shall we? The Celtics scored, what, 66 points in the paint, 17 points from free throws, and 30 from the three-point line, which totals to, if my math is right, 113 points. Only 2 points actually came from the mid-range, and yet, Boston lost. In other words, despite their ideal shot profile, Ridhima, they lost.
Both teams, as we saw today, have their strengths and weaknesses, and after game one, in the playoffs, it's all about adjustments.
Very true. And that's another place I see an advantage for the 76ers, actually, Ridhima. The coach in particular, Doc Rivers, is playoffs tested and is willing to adapt and make smart tweaks this postseason. I mean, just look at how he enabled James Harden, who tied his playoff career high with 45 points and counting. Unbelievable.
Yep, we'll be speaking of coaches and adjustments. The Phoenix Suns and Denver Nuggets series is just as intriguing because both coaches are just masters in game adjustments. And personally, I'd love to see the Suns reach the finals and win it all. Perfect redemption story. What do you think? But let's just talk about the game one, Anant. You know, it looked like a dominant one by the Nuggets, and they were able to get the best out of their two stars. Well, Jokic was just masterful with 24 points and 19 rebounds, and Jamal Murray added 34 points as well.
That's true. And guess what happens in game two? The Nuggets go 2-0 up as well. And once again, back-to-back NBA MVP, that's Nikola Jokic, producing a performance which you can call stellar because it wasn't the greatest shot-making on display. But at the same time, sometimes the great players have to come to the fore, and that's exactly what Jokic did. Now, home court advantage for Denver Nuggets, capitalized fully.
Well, let's just shift gears to the East, where we saw the revival of an old school rivalry. Between the Heat and the Knicks, the action on display was just sensational. So fans, we have some amazing basketball action that you can catch every night that's on display.
Yes, I think Jimmy Butler was a man possessed in game one. Butler had 25 points and even had 11 rebounds for the Heat, Ridhima.
Yep, and the number 8 seeded Heat kept rolling after barely reaching the postseason, beating the New York Knicks 108-101 on Sunday in game one. Now, RJ Barrett scored 26 points and Jalen Brunson had 25 for the 5th seeded Knicks, who are in the second round of the playoffs for the first time since 2013. The Golden State Warriors fans will be just as vocal at the Chase Center. In game one, between the Lakers and the Warriors, truly a special moment, you know, Anant, because Curry versus LeBron in the playoffs is a special occasion for all sports fans. And I would say that this, you know, is probably the last few times we've seen both of them pitted against each other. It's like MS Dhoni in IPL.
And guess what, guys? You can catch the two teams in action on Sunday, the 7th of May at 6 a.m. Nice and early for Game 3 on Sports 18, Jio Cinema and MTV.
And if things work out, that's not how you pass.
Okay.
Pass it again? Yeah. And if things work out for one of these teams in the coming week, they could very well be on their way to the Western Conference Finals.
Guys, there's so much at stake and so many fantastic games coming up. These playoffs are absolutely unmissable. But that's a wrap for this edition of The Lowdown. So follow, like and share NBA India on all socials. But until next time,